Well, I didn't know he was going to be here, but you know, it's his honor to introduce him here. I know him, been known Jamel about 6 years now. When he first wanted to get in the political arena, he wanted to run for mayor. He came to me, and I reached out and showed him the love, gave him a campaign headquarters free. You don't remember that, do you? But he's a little controversial in the community, but nevertheless,
that's an understatement.
He knew the word of God. You know, he know the word. I go to his church all the time over there on Hill Street. What's the name of that church again? Mark. New Homes. Go there, listen to him preach to myself. I think that, you know, he do a good job when it comes down to living the word of God. So Jamel and John is still growing like we all are growing in the clerical business. But at this time, I would like to introduce a good friend of mine, Reverend Jamel Brown. Receive him by raising the right hand.
Hallelujah.
Members would have been here, but we had family and friends day this morning, so we did not want to trouble them, but they had an obligation. But more or less, I came to just share a word with you all. Amen. I want to thank Pastor McCoy for the opportunity. He didn't have to do it, but he did. I thank him for his spirit that he has. You have a very wonderful pastor. Amen. Give it up for your pastor this morning. Amen.
All right.
I love nobody. You should take care of your pastor. Amen. I want to thank Mr. Boyd for all he has done for me in my life from the age of 16 to 22. He has been a very instrumental part of my life. He called me his friend, but I call him my father from another mother. I thank you, Mr. Boyd. I thank the deacons. I thank Deacon McCoy. And I thank all of you. Amen.
Amen.
Just a brief word coming out of the book of Mark, chapter number 5. And for your reading, we're going to deal with one verse. But when you go home tonight, I just want you to go over verses 1 through 19 just for your studying. But we're going to deal with the key verse. Chapter 5, verse 19, and said, "Howbeit Jesus suffered him not, but said unto him, Go home to thy friends, and tell them how great things the Lord had done for thee, and had compassion on thee." Amen? I'm not a topical preacher, but for this occasion, I just want to give you a subject. And the subject is the compassion of Jesus. Amen. The compassion of Jesus. If you give it 15 minutes, I'll go ahead and get out your way. But I want to tell you that when Jesus was on the boat, this started while they was traveling to the country. And while they was heading to the country, there was a storm that arose. And Bishop, when the storm came, the disciples were so afraid. They were so troubled, and Jesus was sleeping, and they said, "Master, Lord, do you care?" And Jesus got up and he said, "Oh, ye of little faith." Then he commanded the storm by saying, "Peace,
be still."
Be still.
Right.
And by him saying, "Peace, be still," that led us here in chapter 5 when they came over unto the other side of the sea into a country of the Gadarenes. Verse 2 says, "And when he was come out of the ship, immediately there met him out of the tomb a man with an unclean spirit." This man was a man that came from that country of Galilee. Now, the question that pondered in my mind, Deacon McCoy, is that when he was in the tomb, he had to be put there by somebody. Can I get a witness here? The reason why he was put in the tomb, Sister McCoy, because he was possessed by some demons. Are y'all here with me? The most terrible thing in your life is to be put out of a town that you was born in with your family, your economics, your education.